Throughout the history of the Super Bowl era, there have been some awesome single season teams that also came up short in the only goal that matters, a championship. Some lost on Super Sunday, some failed in the conference championship, and some even failed to get out of the first round of the playoffs. Inside are the 10 greatest single seasons that failed to win a title. Number 10, we have the 1974 Oakland Raiders. This Raiders team might actually have been better than the one that won Super Bowl XI 2 years later. Not only were there two losses by a combined 4 points, but they led the NFL in scoring and didn't have a cupcake like the expansion Buccaneers on their schedule. Furthermore, they officially ended the Dolphins dynasty by defeating Miami in the Sea of Hands game, perhaps the greatest single game in NFL history. But the main reason why they are so high on this list, despite not even reaching the Super Bowl? The offensive balance. Third in the NFL in rushing yards, and first in the NFL in touchdown passes. Their record was 12-2, they were the AFC West champion, their head coach was John Madden, and they lost 24-13 to the Pittsburgh Steelers in the AFC Championship. Number 9, we have the 2009 Minnesota Vikings. It ended on a sour note, Brett Favre's interception in the Superdome. But that Vikings team was special. Favre was the star and made a handful of fine plays on his way to posting career highs in rating and completion percentage, but because they had Adrian Peterson as well, that offense was incredible. So too was that front four with Jared Allen, Ray Edwards, Kevin Williams, and Pat Williams. And even though they lost the game, it's worth pointing out that they kept the great Saints offense largely in check, allowing just 257 total yards. Had it not been for the horrific 5-1 turnover margin, they would have been playing in Super Bowl 44. Their record was 12-4, they are the NFC North champion, their head coach was Brad Childress, and they lost 31-28 in OT at the New Orleans Saints in the NFC Championship. Number 8, we have the 1980 San Diego Chargers. The 1980 Chargers didn't have nearly the same type of balance as the 2009 Vikings or the 1974 Raiders, but with three pass catchers with Kellen Winslow, Charlie Joyner, and John Jefferson, each recording over 70 catches and 1,000 yards, that did not matter. At least until the AFC Championship game. Today we talk about how much the NFL has changed that Aaron Rodgers, Tom Brady, and Drew Brees are putting up amazing statistics through the air, but given the era, Eric Coryell put up relatively more mind-boggling numbers 31 years ago. If they could have just squeezed a little bit more out of that shaky defense against Oakland, they would have been playing Philadelphia in Super Bowl 15. Their record was 11-5, they were the AFC West champions, their head coach was Don Coryell, and they lost 34-27 to the Oakland Raiders in the AFC Championship. Number 7, we have the 1992 San Francisco 49ers. From 1992 to 1995, there was little question as to who the two best teams in the NFL were. It was either Dallas then San Francisco, or San Francisco then Dallas. And that trend began in 1992. There's a reason why in 1995 Sports Illustrated called the NFC Championship game the real Super Bowl. With Steve Young emerging as an MVP, Jerry Rice being Jerry Rice, and Ricky Widers becoming a feature back, the 49ers offense was every bit as explosive as it had been during the latter parts of the 1980s. And since the defense allowed less than 15 points per game, few teams in NFL history sported that type of balance. The only thing that truly separated this 49er team from the Super Bowl champion Cowboys was a lack of ball security. They turned the ball over 8 times in 2 playoff games, and that ultimately cost them a shot at the Super Bowl. Their record was 14-2, they were the NFC West champions, their head coach was George Seifert, and they lost 30-20 to Dallas Cowboys in the NFC Championship game. Number 6, we have the 2001 St. Louis Rams. The greatest show on turf, part 2. Some believe that Mike Martz's play calling, a failure to utilize Marshall Faulk enough, was as much the reason the Patriots won Super Bowl 36 as Tom Brady, Bill Belichick, or Adam Vinatieri. But that's a debate for another slideshow. But what's not debatable is how great this Rams team was. Faulk was the league's most versatile running back, Kurt Warner won a second MVP in 3 seasons, and Torrey Holt had 2 more years of experience, becoming one of the game's best wide receivers. The defense also pulled its weight that season. Leonard Little and Grant Wistrom were excellent pass rushers, London Fletcher was a tackling machine, and the secondary was excellent with Anus Williams and Dre Bly. No wonder John Madden thought the Patriots should have played for overtime. Their record was 14-2, they were the NFC West champions, head coach was Mike Martz, and they lost 20-17 to the New England Patriots in Super Bowl 36. Number 5, we have the 1966 Dallas Cowboys. This is the Dallas team that first earned the inevitable nickname, Next Year's Champion. Of all the early Cowboys teams that came so close to a Super Bowl title, the losers in the Ice Bowl, the team that Cleveland pounded in the 1969 playoffs, the addition that gave away Super Bowl 5 with late turnovers, this was the best. Part of the reason why was the quarterback. but this Cowboys team also had Bullet Bob Hayes at his absolute peak and two very strong running backs in Dan Reeves and Don Perkins. And this early incarnation of the Doomsday defense was far younger and just as talented. Bob Lilly, Chuck Helley, Ralph Neely, George Andre, Lee Ray Jordan, Cornell Green, and Mel Renfro were each all pros. Their record was 10-4, they were the NFL Eastern champion, their head coach was Tom Landry, and they lost 34-27 to the Green Bay Packers in the NFL title game. Number 4, we have the 1998 Minnesota Vikings. Unfortunately for Minnesota fans, this is the second different Vikings team to make this list. That's fitting since this was by far the most heartbreaking team in franchise history, perhaps in NFL history. That offense was incredible, scoring more points than any team ever. Randall Cunningham was reborn, Robert Smith ran with great consistency, and Randy Moss and Chris Carter were probably the greatest pair of wide receivers in history. Couple that with a pretty good defense, with a kicker who literally didn't miss, and they were Super Bowl bound, headed for a dream matchup against John Elway's Broncos. You know the rest, of course. Gary Anderson missed the game-sealing field goal, Atlanta came back to defeat them, and Minnesota still hasn't recovered. Their record was 15-1, they are the NFC Central champion, their head coach was Dennis Green, and they lost 30-27 in overtime to the Atlanta Falcons in the NFC Championship. Number 3, we have the 1968 Baltimore Colts. This team had not one, but two MVP quarterbacks, Johnny Unitas and Earl Morrall, the era's greatest tight end, John Mackey, as well as the NFL's best defense. Chuck Knoll's unit recorded 4 shutouts that year, allowed 1 or fewer touchdowns in 12 of their 17 games, and surrendered just 10.4 points per game. So there's little wonder to why they were 18-point favorites against the puny New York Jets. And as the saying goes, that's why they play the games. Baltimore's offense could do nothing right, and the defense gave up just enough to Joe Namath's offense to fall into a hole that even Unitas couldn't dig them out of. The record was 13-1, they are the NFL Coastal Champion, their head coach was Don Shula, and they lost 16-7 to the New York Jets in Super Bowl III. Number 2, we have the 1990 Buffalo Bills. Only one Bills team made this list and, not surprisingly, it's the team that came literally inches from a Super Bowl championship. Although the three teams that followed also reached the Super Bowl, this was the only one that put up a real fight and was also the most balanced and healthiest. With Andre Reed and James Lofton as the prime targets, Jim Kelly ran the K-gun to perfection while Thurman Thomas emerged as perhaps the NFL's most valuable player. And with NFL Defensive Player of the Year Bruce Smith playing in front of a trio of great linebackers in Shane Conlin, Daryl Talley, and Cornelius Bennett, the Bills' defense was outstanding. There was no better case of balance than their 51-3 blowout of the Raiders in the AFC title game. Scott Norwood's narrow miss of a very difficult field goal is the lone reason why this team is here and not on a list of great Super Bowl winners. Their record was 13-3, they were the AFC's champion, their head coach was Marv Levy, and they lost 20-19 to the New York Giants in Super Bowl 25. Number 1, we have the 2007 New England Patriots. This should be a no-brainer. That Patriots team set an NFL record for most points scored, Tom Brady rewrote the record books, they had a dynamic pair of receivers with Randy Moss and Wes Welker, and the defense was ranked 4th in the NFL in points allowed. But the Giants' pass rush harassed Brady to the point where he never got in sync, and because they couldn't really run the ball with much efficiency, the offense fell woefully short of their weekly average. Their record was 16-0, they were the AFC East champions, head coach was Bill Belichick, and they lost 17-14 to the New York Giants in Super Bowl 42. That's it for today's video, thank you for watching. Comment below and let me know which team you think was the best team to not win a Super Bowl. And if you like this video, please subscribe.